You're listening to the Monday Night Community Show with Daniel on BRFM.
This is the Daniel Monday Night Community Show on demand through YouTube. Thank you very much for choosing to listen to us through this method. If you'd like to keep up to date with when I add new interviews, then subscribe to this channel. With Ian, who is the Soilborough Council Seafront Officer, and also Matt, he's the RLNI Supervisor, Lifeguard Supervisor, is here in Swale. A little bit later on, I've got a couple of interviews, one all about how people are sort of ditching dairy more. So we've got some info on that. We've also got one all about apprenticeships. So if you're interested in apprenticeships or heard about, I'm not quite sure. We've got a little interview talking all about that. We've also got the next part of our radio patch. It's the final part this week of the Gold Star Kid. And as always, we've got the very popular Let's Talk Business after 9 o'clock as well. Firstly, as always, it's great to have you both in the studio. I think I'm going to be speaking to you first, Ian.
Hi, Dan. Thanks for inviting us back. Good to be back.
So, what has been going on along the seafront during the summer?
Well, we had a really lovely June, but then the weather was not so good this year until perhaps the last few weeks of the summer holidays. I was pleased mainly to see the Guardians of the Deep project come to fruition. It's been about 3 years in the making. From the Kent Wildlife Trust, and we've seen a beach school implemented with the local Minster Primary School, which my boy was lucky enough to take part in, where they've gone down to the beach and done a few educational things. They also provided a free rock pooling event at Mr. Lee's, which went really well, so we'll be looking to do them sort of things in the future. We also hosted the third annual Classic Car Show with the Sweetheart along Minster Lee's, and again that was a roaring success. Which everyone really looks forward to now every year. The RNLI hosted their open day at the Queen Broadtide Landing. Again, a successful event. It's just a shame the boats got called out, but that's the way it goes. And the RNLI also came around for the Classic Car Show and did a joint demo with the lifeguards, which was always pleasing to see and helps raise awareness amongst our users. We also managed to complete the replacement of the old metal bins along the seafront, which is a bit boring, but it's something that pleases me. And then in the last few months, I've supported quite a few voluntary cleans, actually, in parts of the beaches we don't reach every day. And we've been supported by Network Rail at Queenborough, Canterbury College, and the Sheppey Evangelical Church did some voluntary beach cleans, which was really good. Swale Tri Club. I've also hosted some open water events, which I'm really pleased to see, getting people out there doing different kinds of events. So we're always happy to have people approach us if they want to host them kind of events. The Laysdown Beach Huts pilot project got off the ground, so we've got 20 up at Laysdown now, and we're just waiting to see how they go. Also, filming has come to the fore this year. After Robbie Williams filmed his pop video in November, we were deluged with requests for our shellness, so that's going to be a really positive thing for the future, and hopefully in the future a great source of income for us, because we've got such natural resources and lovely scenery. Is something to be utilised. And we've also got a good relationship ongoing with the local environment agency at the moment, and they've been doing quite a little few things along Shinnie Seafront, replacing handrails, dealing with queries as soon as I put them through. So that's been really pleasing for me this summer.
So has there been any issues or problems?
Yeah, again, we a couple of years ago, we had a 4x4 abandoned off of Laysdown Bathing Beach, and again, it happened again this year. All played out in front of social media. But again, it was left to me to get the vehicle off the beach. And what people don't realise, that comes out of my budget, which is effectively taxpayers' money. So it's very disappointing when I could be using that money to improve the beaches. Instead, I'm paying out to remove someone's mistake. Also, we have the ongoing petty vandalism and damage, which is just ongoing. And again, the other big issue around the country and on Sheppey is fly tipping, unfortunately, and it's something we always have to deal with.
Matt, it's great to see you back. And once again, thanks for giving me the chance to come down in the summer and talk to some of the girls. That really worked well.
Yeah, it was nice to see you over the summer a few weeks ago. I was just thinking how last time we met, we were covered in sun cream and fending off the sun. And today we've just kind of driven through thunderstorms and lightning. So it's very different every time I see you. But it's very good to be back.
So how has the 17 season been going for the lifeguards here on the Isle of Sheppey?
Well, for the lifeguards, they've had quite a successful season. We've had no kind of major incidents out in the water that the lifeguards have dealt with. We did have a few early on in the season that the crew from Sheerness dealt with successfully. So in that regard, although it's been a quiet season for guards, it's actually been quite a successful one. We have dealt with 8 major first aids over the season. So those are things that we consider if we hadn't have treated, could have gone a little more seriously. And also the guards have been training quite closely with the crew from Sheerness. So they've been enjoying their time. And as you're aware, they travel over from Thanet each day to come and work on the island. And a good few of them have really fallen in love with the place. It's their first season over here, so... Yeah, they've enjoyed it and we've had a successful season.
So how's it been for you as the supervisor for the first time?
It's been fascinating, challenging and rewarding, if I'm honest. One of my great pleasures has been working with the crew over at Sheerness. We've got a good relationship with them and they're a good set of ladies and gents over there. Again, like I say, I think we've had a successful season with the guards kind of being as proactive as they have been with their prevention. I've enjoyed working in the schools and delivering some assemblies and things like that. So all in all, although it's my first season coming up to managing a team rather than being a lifeguard on the beach, it's been challenging but thoroughly rewarding.
So now the season has ended and the lifeguards are no longer on duty for the day, what advice would you give to people wishing to use the beach over the winter, and what should someone do if they are finding themselves in trouble in the water, or if they see someone in trouble?
Yeah, okay, so there's obviously quite a lot we could cover here, but I think the time for swimming is kind of coming to a close. Obviously the lifeguards aren't there. I think if you are planning to go in the water still, plan to get yourself warm and dry, go in company, so you have someone who can keep an eye on you and stay within your depth as well, whilst there's no lifeguard service out there. If you're actually going out onto the water, whether you're kind of fishing, kayaking and that kind of thing, just make sure all your radios are working and your life vests are in good working order. And it's also the Coast Guard would have no problem with you kind of registering in with them your intended movements. In terms of what people would do if they found themselves in the water, a lot of people who do get into difficulty were never expecting to enter the water in the first place. So, you know, a fisherman never intends to fall overboard or be washed off the rocks. So we have some advice for people who find themselves in water unexpectedly, and that is to float. Which sounds a little simple, but if I explain it like this, once you fall into the water and it's cold, you'll be familiar with losing your breath and you really kind of struggle to gain your breath. You also very naturally take a kind of vertical position and begin to kind of climb in the water. That's actually not very advantageous. The thing that you could do is to float actually on your back. Raise your legs up and kind of spread your arms out. Your lungs kind of naturally will give you buoyancy, and also you can kind of think about regulating your breathing and coming up with a plan. Also, the fascinating thing about this is if you think back when you were a youngster and you go off to the swimming pool and on holiday and you jump in the pool and your shorts would fill with water and with air and your pockets would fill up and you'd quickly squeeze all the water out. By being vertical in the water, you're going to lose all that air. By lying on your back, it traps all of the air within your clothes, which kind of gives you a very natural buoyancy. And by floating, that kind of keeps the air. Once you start to thrash, you lose that air and you kind of become saturated and heavy. So if unexpectedly falling in the water, lie on your back, have a float and kind of come up with a plan of what to do with yourself. And if you see anyone in the water, if you phone 999 and ask for the Coast Guard, they will be able to help you from there.
We're joined in the studio with Ian, who is the Swale Borough Council Seafront Officer, and Matt, who is the RLNI Lifeguard Supervisor here in Swale. So, Ian, what are the plans and upcoming events for the upcoming months?
Well, this Sunday we've got the annual RNLI Sheerness Lifeboat Run. We've been going 26, 27 years now, and is a permanent fixture in the calendar. And that runs from where Cage Casino was up to Minster Leeds, where the prom ends, and all the way back. Simple, flat 5 miles. That's taking place at 10:30 this Sunday. If you'd still like to enter, you can enter on the day or go and get an application form from Sheppey Leisure Complex reception. So that's coming up Sunday. This Friday, we see this weekend being the Marine Conservation Society's annual Great British Beach Clean. And I'll be doing one on Friday morning at Walden Bay Beach at 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. If you're coming, I'll bring a coat and some sturdy footwear. And also the Guardians of the Deep Project are running one at Minster Leeds Beach, and they're going to be 10 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. and they're going to be meeting at a little Oyster car park. So please do take your pick which one you'd like to do. Over the winter I'll be doing the usual award flag applications. This year we didn't get the blue flag for Laysdown because of one dodgy result last summer, but this year we've also been chosen as part of the Southern Water Bathing Water Enhancement Programme to have some investment and work done to Minster Leeds and Laysdown, looking at trying to get the long-term sustainability of the beaches to excellent. So hopefully in future years all three beaches will get excellent all of the time, and that's my main objective with that. Also over the winter personally I'm going to be doing a seafront signage audit, because there's some signs there what need to be taken down. So I'll be biking along all the seafronts and taking pictures and making notes, so that'll be something to keep me busy over the winter.
So what advice do you have for beach users from the council's perspective?
Well, always please do use the bins or take your rubbish home, especially if it can be recycled. Use your recycling bins at home if you can. There's no excuse now. I've got plenty of bins along the seafront. We empty them daily. Or as I say, please do take your rubbish home. There's no excuse really. If you see antisocial behaviour happening, please do report it to the police. If you don't, they won't know. So please do dial 101, or if it's a crime taking place, please dial 999 and report it immediately. As I say, with my budget, a lot of it is spent in replacing damaged, vandalised items, which could be used to improve the seafronts. And also, please remember, as Matt was saying, the hashtag Respect the Water campaign, and that's not just for the summer, that's for all year round. Dial 999 if you see anyone in difficulty. Know your tides and know your weather conditions as well.
Matt, how has the local recruitment issue gone this year?
Well, it's been reasonably successful, if I may say so. Although we've not got any guards that are resident from the island, what we've managed to do is build some good relationships with the Sheerness Lifeguard Club over in Sheerness, who have a few youngsters that are looking to join the service next year. We also have a nice partnership with them where we kind of share equipment with them and get involved with some of their training with the Sunday morning, so we're kind of doing all right there. We've also had some interest from some of the sixth formers from the academy, the Oasis Academy, at the start of this season. So we're still in touch with them to progress them maybe next year. But we're also kind of thinking a little more, around the picture than just school leavers joining us. So we're going to try and work maybe with the fire brigade and police departments on the island, and kind of looking there for similar emergency service personnel who can kind of come on board, also maybe recruit volunteers around and about. So we're thinking of different ways to skin the cat, as it were, than just find youngsters to come join us. We're making headway, but it's a long process.
So do you have any sort of future courses coming up, and how can people find out information if they are interested?
We don't have any courses booked in at the moment. Obviously, coming into winter, we're not going to be doing those with the sea getting colder. We will, however, be starting those up kind of from April into May, over that Easter period. So if you want any information on those courses, my email address would be matthew_jones4@rnli.org.uk. Alternatively, if you follow the RNLI website, which is rnli.org, and follow that through to the lifeguard page there, you get information about job opportunities and potential courses in the area. Failing that, we also have a Twitter handle, which is at RNLI Lifeguards Southeast, which is Lifeguards SE. So if you want to get in touch there, you can do.
Now, before you both go, I was just hoping that, Ian, you could give us any sort of useful contact details, info, anything else you'd like to cover.
Yeah, certainly. People wish to ring me, my office number is 01795 667015. Please don't be put off if you get the answer phone. I'm generally with my job, I'm at the office quite a lot, so please either leave me a message or drop me an email on Ian Arnell, and that's all one word, @swell.gov.uk.
Well, Ian and Matt, I'd like to thank you very much, both of you, for coming
thank
along
you.
Once again.